HTTP is a protocol. Like other protocols, it defines a language that clients and servers can use to communicate with each other. HTTP defines a set of requests that clients can make to the server to do various types of things. It also defines how the server can respond. There are lots of different types of HTTP requests. There may be like a dozen or so, but there's only really a couple that you really have to know and understand to do a lot of work online and to understand a lot of what's going on online, because they're the most common ones by far. So the most common by far is something called GET. GET is what it sounds like. It asks the server to send the client some information. The information could be a web page, could be some CSS that shows how the web page is supposed to look, could be an image that's included in the web page, whatever. The semantics are that GET can return really any kind of data. And GET is used not only on the web, but really all over the place now as sort of a general purpose tool for retrieving data from a server. So GET is super important. I suspect that maybe 90, 95, 98% of the requests that web servers see are GET requests. The other request is POST. POST is a little bit different, but POST is actually also something that you do a lot, even if you're not aware of it. Every time you submit a form, whether you're buying something, logging into a website, creating an account, you're submitting a POST request. And POST is allowed to change state on the server. So we'll look at both of these quickly to give you a sense of how a lot of the things that you do online actually happen. So I have a couple of simple pages here I'm going to use as examples. I've got my Chrome Developer Tools open, and I know it says complex page, but it's still pretty simple. So I've got it open to my network tab. I'll zoom in here so you can see what's going on. And I'm going to reload this page, and we'll see what happens over on the right here, okay? So I reload the page, and what I can see happening is that loading this page involved the client, my web browser, making a series of, in this case, five, did I count that right? Five GET requests. The first one was actually for the location that's in the address bar. So if I go over here, the location is example/complex.html. And if I go down here, I can see that the first GET request was for example/complex.html. So that's the first thing I asked the server for. I said, please give me this web page. The server responded with that page. Once the client received that page, it realized that it needed to fetch a few more resources so that it could render the complete page. One of those resources is this very nice picture of a kitty that was part of the page. There's also a CSS file that was included that shows how the page is supposed to look, and then a couple of pieces of JavaScript that provide some of the features provided by the Bootstrap library, and also jQuery, which is used to manipulate the DOM. So this is pretty common. I ask for a web page, I get the initial page back, and then I create several other requests. And you can see up here in the timeline this is going on. So this was the first request for the page, and then once I have that web page, I look at it, and then I know I need a couple other things to render it, and so those requests actually happen in parallel. And you can see that the request that takes by far the longest here is this cat picture, and that's because that's the largest part of the page. Okay, so this is GET. This is how GET works. Now let's look at a simple form, an example of the type of thing you do a lot where you submit some data to a website. This could be a username and password to log into something. This could be you clicking accept when you purchase something. This could be clicking buy when you want something to appear at your house and you're willing to let someone charge your credit card some money. It could be all sorts of different things. So whenever you see a form and there's a submit button, what's likely going to happen when you click that button is that it's going to generate a POST request. So let's see how that works. So let me load this page. Now, if you look over here, when I load this page, I'm issuing entirely GET requests. So these are GET requests. There's four in this case. Now I have the page loaded, but let me go over here and interact with that page, and I'm going to submit something. I'm going to submit test. I've got my network console open here so I can see what happens. Okay, boom. Check this out. So over here, I see something different. I see that I've made a POST request. That POST request transmitted, in this case, that information to the server. And if I click on it, I could actually go down here and see down to the very bottom. Oh, sorry, this was the request headers. Ah, here we go. Request headers. I can see the headers for the request I made, and then, oh wait, here we go, form data, right? So here's the actual data that I submitted to the server. Let me get out of the way here. And I submitted the text was the name of the form field, and the value was test. So this is how data gets to the web server frequently, particularly when I'm submitting forms, bind things, whatever. The post method, in comparison with other ways of getting data to the server, is a little bit more secure, and it's frequently used when there's a transaction involved. Post is allowed to change something about the world. That's one of the differences between it and get. So what about other parts of the HTTP protocol? So there's a bunch of these. I'm not going to talk about them in detail. There's something called head, which retrieves the page headers, but not the page contents. It's sort of like get, but rather than getting the page contents, I just get headers for the page. You might wonder, why is this useful? Get is a great way to check if a page exists. Is a link dead? Rather than having to suck the whole page down when I don't really even care, I just issue a head request, and then all the server will tell me is, yeah, you're good to go, that page is still there. Sweet. There's some parts, some additional HTTP commands that are used in what are called RESTful web APIs, put and delete. Delete does kind of what it sounds like. It's allowed to remove a resource from the server. Put is designed to upload a representation of a particular resource to the server. There's something called options. Options allows a client to retrieve, to ask the server, what sort of other methods do you actually support for this particular path? So there's a bunch of different parts of the HTTP protocol. These aren't even all of them. But really, if you know GET and you know POST, you know most, you can understand most of what goes online and most of the types of conversations that go on using the HTTP protocol.